Hi, John here. This is a quick video which I promised to reveal our new EV. So I'm going to tell you what it is very soon. I won't keep you hanging on too long. But also talk through what we chose and why we chose it, really. I think that's probably more important for a lot of people than what we actually ended up with. So what was our thought process and our decision-making process? So once the Hyundai had gone and been picked up by Hyundai, or the AA in fact, we were at a point where we needed a second EV. We decided not to have two long-range cars anymore. It just didn't seem much point. Previously, we had the Kona, which is a 300-mile range EV, plus the Tesla, 300-mile range EV. And, you know, we're only going to use one with us both in if we're doing long trips anywhere. So we decided to get a second EV, which would just do local runs. And we're talking sort of 10 miles to the shops and back, you know, is the longest probably they would go. So certainly not a 300-mile range. And we didn't want to spend loads of money on it because it was, by and large, it's just going to be sitting on the drive for a lot of the time. We set a budget of maximum of 20 grand. And the only other criteria was not a Hyundai for obvious reasons. Oh, by the way, if you haven't seen the previous video about the Hyundai, I'll leave a link to it up here. So you can click and go and have a look at that. So with that in mind, those criteria, these are the models that we were shortlisted with. We weren't particularly drawn to any particular model or any particular brand or anything like that. We were quite open as long as they meted the criteria. I guess there were a few things that we didn't like. I wasn't keen on the i3, just from a visual perspective. Julie wasn't keen on the Kia Soul. And to be honest, I wasn't keen on the Soul because it shares the same software as the Hyundai. I've always found the Hyundai software really laggy and slow to actually do anything. So that sort of put me off. So that sort of limited us a bit. Put out on Twitter that the Hyundai had gone, and loads of people really were helpful actually and gave us some suggestions and what was about and what was on the market. And then the Plug Seeker, who I follow on Twitter, sent me this DM message, which was really, really helpful. Quite a few actually I didn't know about, which was nice. So there was 12 there in total, and I visited each one of their website. I phoned up a few of them and spoke to them. And there were a few cars that I looked at. Nissan Leafs was coming up as a popular option, as were the Zoes. But eventually I chose one, and I've already teased you with this picture here. So let's show you in a little bit more detail what it is. So that's who we got it from. So Go Green Autos. I'll talk more about those in a minute. Matt at Go Green. Yeah, so it's a Zoe, a 22 kilowatt Zoe. This is one that's battery leased. It was previously battery leased, and the battery has been purchased. So it's an owned version, battery-wise. There's two, if you're not familiar with the Zoe, the early ones, you can either get them lease, where you pay sort of 60 quid a month for battery lease, or buy the car outright with the battery. So I said we went to Go Green Autos Limited. Matt was extremely helpful there, as were everyone I spoke to be honest. But Matt had a car which wasn't on his website, and he just got in as a part exchange. He hadn't prepped it, and it wasn't on his website for sale. So I sort of jumped in really early. Just to give you an idea of what Matt did, this is a normal process for explaining to customers, either that if they're new to EV or like us, experienced in EV. He does loads of videos and sends updates to customers, which I found really useful, because with these updates, I knew all about the car. When it arrived on the day, I knew all about it and its state of health and everything. So I had complete confidence it was going to be exactly as described.
So just a quick update on the car. The service is underway. The air conditioning is being regassed as we speak. Change the cabin filter. And while this air conditioning is going to be done, doing all the checks in the under the bonnet there. So yeah, I'll update you next week. So the drop links have been changed. If you don't know what these are, they are a bar that goes between your anti-roll bar and the side of the strut here. And
While they weren't bad on this, they were normal, you know, for 25,000 miles. They do take a lot of wear, and for some reason on the Renault Zoes, they do wear out prematurely. On modern cars, they've become almost a service item now. On old cars, they used to last like, you know, 150,000 miles or so. On modern cars, they now typically last sort of 80 to 100,000. For some reason on the Zoe, they're half that again. These obviously corrode, surface corrosion, it does no harm at all. It's just visual. You know, it just looks worse than it is. Surface corrosion on this is completely normal. But I do like to paint them just because it tidies the car up. And because I do this sort of three-stage rust protection, a lacquer, and then the top coat is actually brake caliper paint, which is really tough. That finish is actually better than it is from the factory on the original part. And we can see all the voltages of all the cells, and they all look nice and equal. And going through all the cells, and then we can see the more cells, more voltages. So yeah, they all look good. Just quickly scroll through this lot, and then we've got temperatures, 5 degrees, the battery pack is, that's obviously internally. There we go. Traction battery condition, it is at 98% state of health, so all good. There's the mileage of the battery, that's in kilometres.
So, I said I'll do a final review video on the condition. I know it's a bit late now because you have paid for the vehicle. But, you know, you bought this one before it was ready and videoed. So, yeah, you're going to get that. But anyway, it's an exceptional condition one, this one. If you see my videos before, you know I point out things that most people just really wouldn't care about. So on this one, there's a couple of little things I'm going to show you, which I found now it's clean, because you only get to properly see the condition of a vehicle when it's clean. There is this pinprick dent here in the boot, which is very small. I found another one on the driver's door here somewhere, which I can't see now. Oh, there it is, further back a little bit. Another tiny little pinprick dent there, but very small. And really nothing to worry about. Yeah, those rear drums really are looking better. You know, normally any motor dealer just wouldn't bother doing that sort of thing, because there's nothing wrong with the corrosion, it's all normal. But yeah, it looks so much better. And worth the effort in my view, because, you know, I treat the cars as if they were my own, and it's not that much work while the wheels are off and when it's on a ramp and you've got a bit of time to do that sort of thing, and that will just last for years and years now. So yeah, that's it. Really immaculate on the outside, just those two tiny little pinprick dents. So much, much better than you would normally, much better condition. Oh, we'll be taking the number plates held on by rivets from Renault dealers, and then when you take them out, they drop into the boot, and everyone leaves them. But I take the boot apart and fish them out, because only it will only rattle when you go over bumps. And it's actually very common. A lot of people complain on Zoes about rattle in the back, and it's always just because the number plates have got changed, and no one bothers to fish out the back of those rivets. This will be finished cleaning today. It will also be waxed, and the interior will be cleaned, so by the morning it will all be dry. I'm also going to leave a dehumidifier in the car overnight to really get all that moisture out.
And it's a great little car. Julie and I really, really love it. It's got its sort of typical French Renault quirks. Nothing horrendous, just a few things to get used to. So we're really happy with it. And it's one of those cars that's really been looked after by the previous owner. So we're very lucky from that perspective. One of the nice things we've already noticed is its AC charging is really rapid. It's got a 22 kilowatt onboard AC charger. So at home, for instance, on our Zappi, it'll take up to 8 kilowatts without any problem. And we've popped down to Rushden Lakes in it on the 18th of January and did two charges, just out of curiosity, really. The first charge we did was only 8 minutes, and it added 400 watts. And that was on a 7 kilowatt charger. I then moved to a 22 kilowatt charger, and we were there 18 minutes, and it added 2.8 kilowatt hours. So it's phenomenal how quickly it'll suck up the juice on a three-phase 22 kilowatt charger. So yeah, dead impressed. So there we go. That's it. That's why we've got the Zoe. Price-wise, it came in at £13,000. Not much more I can tell you, really. Really happy with it. Any questions or queries, then give us a shout down in the comments below and I'll pick them up. All right, take care. Bye.